I honestly don't think there's any evidence here, which is which is gonna help me. Oh shit, I've got zero health. Oh my god. I think I need to think a bit more about this. Oh, I've come back to the criminal affairs department. It's given me a this screen. Oh, Mr. Rat, please, you have to help me.
Uh-oh.
Oh, it's Mr. Powers.
Mr. Powers? We sound a lot like Larry Butts there for a second. I'm a good actor.
What happened? Why are you here?
You see, I got roped into this somehow.
What?
And now I'm going to testify tomorrow's trial.
So the deciding witness is Mr. Powers.
I was talking with the detective until a little while ago. I was on my way home. When all of a sudden, you there, you're under arrest. That was brought back here.
Uh-oh.
They said my face on whole 7 camera looked suspicious or something.
Well, I guess I can say how they thought you looked suspicious.
I'm just a normal guy on an exercise show for kids. Is that a crime?
Oh, he's little hanky.
Okay, can you tell me anything? So, about the testimony you're giving, what are you going to talk about?
I really don't know yet. But it sounds like I saw something pretty important from what they tell me.
You saw something important? What was it?
Well, the detective told me not to talk about it. You can't tell anyone, especially not that lawyer, he said.
Who do you think is that lawyer the detective was talking about?
I'm gonna take a wild guess and say it's me.
Yeah, you got it.
Mr. Nick! Mr. Kamai, myself and your other two allies in this whole world, but it's alright.
Ouch. We really have a lot of friends, do I?
Okay. This is going to do a lot of damage to Matt, you know. He's constantly refreshing like a spring breeze in its going.
What is he really like?
Yeah, let's see. Matt's always been kind of a player with women. But never really turn a pretty face away, if you know what I mean. He always says it's just a game to justify himself.
What? How horrible! That's unforgivable!
Sorry, didn't mean to offend you. But you know, he said once that there's only one person in the world who won't swoon over me.
One person who won't swoon over him?
His manager, you know, Miss Adrian Andrews.
Why is Mr. Parson looking kind of energetic?
Oh, he loves gossip, doesn't he?
You see, I'm actually a sucker for gossip. I mean, celebrities in their world has a dazzling sort of image, right?
Dazzling sort of image? Aren't you part of that dazzle, Mr. Powers?
No, I'm more of a hairy, sweaty, smelly, brutish kind of guy, you see. But he's okay, really. I got to hear plenty of gossip about a lot of other stars around where things happen.
Well, that's true.
Oh, hey, so did you hear about this yet? About Miss Andrew's mentor and her suicide?
You mean Miss Impex?
We heard something about how her wedding was cancelled.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. Sort of our solicitors the other day, but that mysterious death. Hey, Mr. Wright, why don't you ask me about that? Go on, go ahead.
The powers are so charged up, his skin is practically glowing with electricity.
Okay, what about it?
Yes, yeah, so have you heard this? So let's lift a suicide note. The 7th one went unheeded.
We heard about that in court today. There wasn't any actual proof that she had left a note.
Well, this is what I think. I think that something bad was written on that note. Something bad for Juan, that is.
Something bad for Mr. Carita.
Why do you figure so?
Well, before she died, let's talk to a few of her friends. And she said, looks like I may have been caught by an insidious man.
Insidious man? I mean, Mr. Carita by that.
Well, there's no one else that fits the bill, right? That would be reason enough for him to hide the suicide note.
I see. Well, that's some good info. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Stoneguard and Miss Andrews are both at the detention center right now. Still things I don't understand or know about, I'm sure. I'll be having two of them to tell me everything.
Hello, phone.
Mr. Nick, your phone!
Yeah, that's a Steel Samurai theme song, isn't it?
It's such a cool song.
I don't have a sound of his ringtone right now. Sounds kind of ominous.
Yeah, I know.
Hello?
We're in trouble now, pal. I'll be back at the office really soon.
What's wrong?
Really unexpected just happened. Mr. Edgeworthy?
Edgeworth?
Anyway, hurry up and get back to the office, pal. Don't know what's going on anymore. It's no good, Deanna.
Hello? Got cut off.
Well, what's going on, Mr. Nick?
I'm sure you said we needed to get back to the office right away.
Then we should hurry back.
It's good to go back.
What are you talking about, Mr. Nick? Pull yourself together.
This sounds mildly terrifying.
Maybe it'll be good news.
Somehow I doubt that. Okay, fine. Can we take this guy over? He's a big burly man. Okay, what's happening? To say it's like 9 o'clock, it isn't half broad daylight outside.
Hey, pal! Stranger's already back.
Well, what happened?
We got him. We know about that spy camera.
But this quickly?
And this bear's what gave it away, pal.
The bear.
I'll figure it out, pal. Figured out we should have been looking into the bear instead of the camera.
I thought that was Edgeworth.
Was it that Mr. Edgeworth that figured...
Shh, Purse.
And go on. There's only one person who bought one of those bears who's related to this crime.
Well, who is it? Who would be so rude as to spy another person in their room?
But on guard.
Huh?
But on guard, your client, that's it, pal.
And here I thought things couldn't get any worse. Okay, tell us more. But first, behold, my badge.
Look, it's my attorney's badge. Oh, it's a little tarnished, don't you think, pal?
You've said this before. Okay, let's talk about the stuffed bear.
I assure you heard right. The person who bought this bear was...
Heard it from the department store clerk, pal.
This is a credit card receipt for the purchase.
It's for $3,800, pal. It's the exact match to the price of that stuffed bear.
Receipt? That's all you have?
Nah, it's not just a receipt, pal. The store clerk said so himself. He told me, sure I saw this bear to Mr. Engard.
I mean, the clerk even got Mr. Engard's autograph out of it, pal.
So I'm sure the person that bought this stuffed bear was Mr. Engard himself.
But my sight is failing me. This can't be.
Oh, shit.
So what about the spy camera we found?
That was a dead end, pal. But you can't get this kind of thing from anywhere. But for now, I guess I can give these back to you for you to find a way to evidence. Okay.
I know I don't want to give up, pal.
I never thought... I didn't think it was possible. First you put the spy camera in Juan Cruz's room was mad on guard.
Why would Mr. Engard do something like this?
But it was to catch Mr. Andrews and Mr. Creator in one of their rendezvous.
I bet it's not good enough for me. I have to know the absolute truth behind this camera.
Are you gonna see him, Mr. Engard, I mean?
Yes.
I'm scared, Mr. Nick. I wonder what we'll find out next.
Scared myself, but I have to put a good face on Pearls. Man on guard, what in the world have you done?
Oh shit. We must find the truth. Okay, fine then. Let's go harass Mr. Man on guard. Hi.
You're waking me in the heat, you know. It's already past 10 PM, dude.
Thing is, Damien told me the truth.
Relax, don't you know that ignorance is bliss? If you really want to know, let's talk.
Behold.
Myers Megatama. Now let's see what this secret of yours is. Mr. Creator had been successful in his plan. What would he have disclosed?
Told you before, dude. I don't know. Don't know anything about what, okay? Look, Mr. Rat, can't keep on saying it until I'm blue in the face, but... Totally didn't pay Juan any attention the whole time that night. I mean, come on. I was in the middle of a nap.
Don't lie to me.
Huh?
I know you paid close attention to Miss Creta, especially on that night.
Behold. Someone used this camera to secretly film Mr. Creed's room the night of the murder.
Secretly film? What?
And then sent the images the camera took with this transmitter.
Wow, but dude, what is this camera you're talking about hidden?
This bear. The spy camera was hidden in this bear's eye. The bear was supposed to be a present from a fan.
I guess Ren had a few of those kinds of fans too, huh, dude?
Actually, I wouldn't say this bear was a present from a fan.
Are you sure, dude? Where else could it be from?
The person who gave his bear to Mr. Creator was Matt on guard. Anonymously, I presume.
Mr. on guard, don't you know this bear from somewhere?
Don't think I've ever met Mr. Bear before, dude.
Oh, but he says he knows you. How do you forget such a great friend?
What else did the bear tell you?
Says that the one who put the camera in his eye was you, Mr. on guard.
If I didn't know how you work in court, I think I was in some serious trouble. Come on, this is all a joke, right, dude? You're just pulling my leg.
So you're not ready to give up your secret yet?
Well, do you have any proof you want to show me first?
Here's proof that it was you who put the camera inside the bear.
This receipt, right?
Behold. I have here one credit card receipt, Mr. on guard. It's from when you bought that stuffed bear.
Dude, all I can tell from that is that I spent $3,800. Go to that department store all the time, okay? It's $3,800? It's gonna be the toothbrush I bought that one time.
$3,800 toothbrush?
It's ivory. It's got elephant hair from bristles.
Ew, thin hair? That's what rich people use nowadays. Anyway, the store clerk clearly remembers you and your purchase. After all, you even gave him an autograph, did you not?
Dude, you should have said it earlier. So can I ask you one thing?
Yes?
You're my lawyer, right, dude? So if you are, then why are you looking at stuff like that?
Because I don't know the truth. I can't help you.
Sounds more like stupid lawyer talk to me. Hey, let's stop talking about this, okay?
No, not yet. I don't ask why you set the camera up yet. And what your secret is. Of course. It'll be strictly confidential.
So, what are you gonna do now?
I'm gonna find out what I wanna know. Because I must. The reason you hid this camera in Mr. Creator's room and filmed it in secret is...
So, it depends on what sort of approach we're taking here. There's two approaches I can think of at the time being. Is A, he wanted to confirm that Daykiller killed this guy, and that's if he's actually hiring the assassin. Or B, he wanted to confirm what Creator was going to say. But the time of being set for 8 o'clock means... updates radio waves and transmits the data. 8 p.m. for 1 hour. Was running at time of murder.
What is this card?
Maybe he doesn't know about this card. It's a certain man's calling card. The man's name is Shelley the Killer. I'm sure you know of him, don't you?
Shelley the Killer? That's ridiculous! Why would I know so much some shady scumbag like him?
If you really don't know him, then why are you acting so jumpy all of a sudden? This is it. I'm finally starting to get to the truth. I can't afford to make any more mistakes now. Mr. Mod on guard, I know why I know Mr. the Killer. It's because you're a hero of justice! You're
his client.
Since you're the one who set up that camera, means you knew. You knew exactly what was going to happen in that room. So, how? How do you know something like that? It's because you're his client. That's why. You hired Shelley the Killer to assassinate Mr. Juan Carita. The real mastermind behind this whole murder is... you, Mad on guard.
You Here I was, trying to be a good boy for you, dude. I thought if you didn't know, you'd be able to do your job without feeling bad. Well, that's what I thought anyway.
But Mr. Ungard, you really did hire...
Hold on a sec. I'll consult myself, okay?
Consult myself?
Well, I guess it's probably about time anyway.
About time for what?
I think it's time for you to meet him now, Mr. Lawyer Dude.
Who's him? Oh shit! Oh my god, he looks like Von Karma. Oh shit, he's evil. How do you do, Mr. Lawyer? I'm Man on Guard. Oh shit. Oh, real shit.
He's got wine or whatever the hell that is, the blood of his enemies!
It's scary, Miss. Well done, Mr. Wright. I bet it wasn't easy to gather as much information as you have. You really? So you wish other to kill his clients? You don't really think I would do it in my own hands, Miss, do ya?
What do you mean?
That woman, Adrian, was quite brave herself. Trying to stick the crime on me. I didn't think she had it in her. But all I care about is that Juan is dead. Isn't that right, Mr. Lawyer?
That's... You're lying! What a terrible...
It's way past your bedtime, little girl. Go on and let us grown-ups talk about more adult things.
Why did you hide the video camera in?
A weakling soon believes the words of others. Just like that pathetic Adrian. You know about Miss Andrews' secret? But I'm no weakling. I don't believe anyone. Least of all assassins. What? Oh, come now, Mr. Wright. Assassins aren't above blackmail. They turn their clients into cash cows by holding the sinful deed over their heads. And a superstar like me, how much do you think I'm worth? Care to guess?
And that's why...
Yeah, that's where the video comes in. It's got his face and the crime scene recorded on it, preserved for all time. With that, I can keep him at bay, even blackmail him if I want. That's right, that video is my insurance. Isn't that what they call it, Mr. Rat?
Why would you do something so wrong?
Because I'm a grown-up, and I can. Got enough of an answer for you, little girl? What's his motive?
Why would you kill Mr. Karina?
He was about to sling so much dung onto my beautiful public image. Scandals are a little annoying, aren't they?
The guy in the box like, oh, what is this? Oh, I love this guy, he's a creeper! My life is over!
So it was about press conference, isn't it?
If Mr. Creed had been able to give it, then Mr. Ungard's secret would have...
Oh well, that's what we call taking advantage of a situation, you know. No interest in doing it really, but bit by bit, crept up on me. Then the situation just presented itself perfectly. How beautiful, I thought.
And that's how Mr. Creed ended up dead.
Let me tell you something. Not like Adrian. I don't depend on anyone. People are simply things to be used. Used and thrown away.
What happened to his face? Did he lose a fight with Sabretooth Tiger or some shit?
Put on a sweet, innocent face and people will swallow anything you feed them. Adrian fell for it. The assassin too. Oh, now can I forget? Even you fell for it, Mr. Lawyer. Everyone are working their butts up for me, Man on Guard. Ah, did I leave you speechless? What a shame. What's wrong, Mr. Lawyer? You've grown awfully quiet. How could I have been so deceived by you all this time? When we first met, I asked if you had killed Juan Carita. You answered very clearly that you hadn't killed anyone. Hey now, I never told you any lies. The person who did the killing was that the killer guy, right? All I'm guilty of is taking a catnap in my room.
You killed Mr. Carita!
I dare to say that in court tomorrow. Ah, but too bad. You can't. You're my lawyer after all, aren't you? Could always drop my case and refuse to represent me. How does that sound? Ah, but you can't, can you? Be one thing you absolutely can't do.
Mr. Kamaya!
You won't want to test Dekila. He's a man of his word. So I hear. Could end up getting a certain friend of yours ripped out if you lose.
You scoundrel!
So if I were you, Mr. Rat Squire, I think I'll give it my all tomorrow. Remember, everyone likes a happy win-win resolution.
I'll get you for this.
Such a cliche phrase. Well, I said something just like that, if memory serves. Of course, well, we all know how well things turn out for him, don't we? Good night, Mr. Lawyer.
Maya, what am I supposed to do?
Hello. Now you finally found it.
Oh, etc.
You sound like Mia.
The starting line of this case.
Edgeworth.
I don't care for the hurried atmosphere here, so turn to the precinct.
March 22nd, police station.
Criminal Affairs Department.
Well, right. What are you going to do? Do you plan on changing your defense?
No! We can't do that!
That's right. It's holding Maya hostage.
What should I do?